Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, here to play Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes on my PlayStation 4 system. I've actually, you know, if you know anything about my channel, I'm a big Metal Gear fan, of course. The minute this game released, I did get it on a different system. I played this on my PlayStation 3. So I've already played this already. I think I played about, I'm trying to remember how much I played it. I think I played like 7 hours in total of it, or 7 to 9 hours, I can't quite remember the exact range of how much I played. But yeah, I did play a heck out of this game. I mean, considering that this game is only 10 minutes long, you know, depending on how quickly you play it, and if you only played it once and just became done with it, and if you're Angry Joe, you probably played for 2 hours and, you know, and call it a day with that. But I really did enjoy the gameplay of this game a lot. It's just kind of the progression of the series as a whole to becoming kind of more the control schemes, like, I think are very different with each Metal Gear game, but I think it got progressively here from 3 to 4 to Peace Walker to this. Ground Zeroes, after all, is a direct continuation in the storyline of Peace Walker. It's like immediately direct continuation. It's like there's not even you know, there's not that much gap, you know, from 1 to 2, the storyline gap is like, I believe, I'm trying to remember, oh my gosh, my saga is messed up now, but I think it's 2 years, right? Or 4, it's either 2 or 4 years after, so 4 years after the events of Metal Gear Solid 1 is 2, and then 3, like, goes all the way back to like 40 years ago in the 60s, and then Portable Ops is a couple of years after 3, Peace Walker is like 9 years after 3, and then Ground Zeroes is immediately afterwards. So just direct continuation kind of makes sense, as controls are very similar to Peace Walker controls, which is very similar to 4 controls. So I think that makes sense. What I think is really cool, so this is my first time playing on a PlayStation 4, which lets me kind of record as I play, which is why I'm able to kind of do this kind of playthrough. The manual is basically goes to a website. It's a web manual, and it's pretty interesting. It lays out the controls. Takes some time because the browser is not super quick. And yeah, I think it's pretty cool. Action type A, shooter type A, vehicles, sneaking, and there's classic kind of these classic pictures. If you remember when you had the manual for Metal Gear Solid 1, I had the first time I got exposed to Metal Gear Solid 1 was the franchise as a whole is Metal Gear Solid 1, the PC version. And the PC version had this thick, really amazing booklet that kind of showed all this stuff, right? Close quarters combat, which is very streamlined in Ground Zeroes, and it's great actually. So definitely a bit more complex than Peace Walker, but a lot more streamlined than, say, Metal Gear Solid 3, which is just the controls of close quarters combat is messy. I did play a bit, like 2 minutes of it, but here we go. I'm gonna start a new mission. I'm gonna try to be as stealthy as possible, trying not to kill as many people as possible. Probably I won't kill anyone, if that can be helped, and play normal. It has been a long time since I played this game on PlayStation 3, but here I go, and we're gonna go through the 10 minutes of cutscenes. Now, Ground Zeroes, I think, was Kojima's effort in saying, like, I'm gonna do less cutscenes. I'm not gonna do any cutscenes now. Right, and this is kind of the backstory, right, which I'm not even going to bother explaining, because that's also one thing I worry about, kind of, when Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain gets released and a lot of people play it. I think a lot of people will probably be confused if they have not played Peace Walker, and that's a lot of people who have not played Peace Walker. Right, Peace Walker is like the least played Metal Gear game as far as the canon, if we're not counting Metal Gear and Metal Gear 2, especially the Japanese version, right? So if we're not counting those, Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker is probably the least played Metal Gear Solid game. And that's kind of troubling, because Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes and Phantom Pain is a very direct continuation of Peace Walker. So for people who have not played Peace Walker, they're going to be fairly lost. And there's a lot of mythos and lore within this entire series, let alone just Peace Walker, that people might get lost on if they have not. And really, like, this game, like Wikipedia and Metal Gear Wiki, kind of doesn't do the whole story aspect justice. You know, there's a lot of things that can be gleaned that needs to be kind of experienced and told through hours and hours of dialogue and audio tapes and cutscenes and kind of gameplay moments. So that's kind of also what I worry about, kind of people that have not ever played Peace Walker or Metal Gear Solid 3. Portable Ops is kind of negligible in terms of storyline, so, you know, people don't need to have played that at all. But especially Peace Walker, right? So this is a direct continuation of that. And so I do kind of worry about how the storytelling will be like to newcomers in the series. Although Ground Zeroes as a premise is very simple. It doesn't feel like... There are some nuances that I get a lot, you know, because I played Peace Walker. Like Ricardo Chico Balancio Libre, like that information right there, it's probably not gonna be all that like, huh, this is Chico, you know, if you haven't played Peace Walker before, right? But Chico is a 14-year-old or 15-year-old, I forget how old he is, but he's a child soldier, practically one of the first child soldiers that Big Boss or Naked Snake recruits. Now this song is been talked about a lot. I didn't know anything about this song before I even saw the trailer for this game or played this game, but it has a, you know, it's very appropriate to the story that we're being told through Ground Zeroes and eventually to by Phantom Pain. It kind of is a song about the anarchists that were Nikolai and, you know, that were tried and executed in America in the 1920s. Something like that. I might be getting the details wrong, but that's kind of the thing about the story. And Ground Zeroes takes place in Cuba, in one of the CIA-operated black sites. And this game kind of tries to really delve into the realistic horrors of war, like torture and American CIA operatives operating outside the rules of war in its own backyard, things of that nature. I've got something else. And this is Kiefer Sutherland voicing Big Boss, which I'm still trying to get used to. You know, I've always, after playing Metal Gear games for so long, you know, saw Snake's voice has always been like David Hayter's kind of gruff impersonation, but whatever the case may be. And also, I think Kiefer Sutherland is an expensive voice actor, so he doesn't talk very much in this game. It's almost like they had to pay him line per line, so they try to give him as least lines as possible, which is also disappointing, you know? I mean, it does kind of make, I don't know, Snake seem smarter because he talks less, but it also... I don't know. That's off-putting to me personally to have Snake talk so little and be unfamiliar to me. So, what was I saying? I was saying a whole bunch of things. Just that, you know, I do wonder how people who are new to this game, this franchise really, Or people who are familiar but have not played Peace Walker. That's also like what I kind of wonder about. Peace Walker is the least played Metal Gear Solid game. The most played Metal Gear Solid game is Metal Gear Solid 2, which sold like 7 million, if we're not counting Substance. I think if we're counting Substance, then it's like 9 million people have played Metal Gear Solid 2. That's the most played. That game has the least relevance to Metal Gear Solid 5. The least relevance. Right, the game with the most relevance is Peace Walker, that's the least played. And then the second most relevance is Metal Gear Solid 3, which is also not as, it wasn't played as much as 1 or 4. So I think a lot of people who end up playing Metal Gear Solid 5 are going to be pretty damn confused in terms of like the back lore and the mythos of the saga. man, the game does look really fantastic on PlayStation 4. I mean, even on PlayStation 3, it was looking really, really good, but the lighting and everything is just fantastic. Definitely, Fox Engine is a graphical powerhouse to behold. A wonder to behold, in a way. So, like, feels very much like a real movie I'm watching. I was also saying that, you know, me personally, I'm not taking as...
So who's the other target? That would be cheap.
You know, that this Metal Gear Solid 5 will be, you know, the least amount of cutscenes in the Metal Gear Saga, whatever. It's not necessarily, like, a very pleasant news to me. I know for a lot of people that is good news because some people complain that, like, oh my gosh, the cutscenes are too long. That was one of the big complaints of Metal Gear Solid 4 especially. I think that's the case. That's also been the case with Metal Gear Solid 2. The two Metal Gear Solid games that people have played, you know, that sold a lot. 4 having sold like 6 million, and again, 2 having sold like 10 million, you know. XOF. I don't really know what the whole deal is about with that. It's some shadowy organization, probably under the auspices of Zero. Yeah, I'm not gonna get too much into the backstory. Maybe as I play through this game and record, I'll talk a lot more about that. But what was I saying?
The politically sensitive nature of
yeah,
the
I mean, you know, people
fine.
Who have
I
not played Peace Walker but are familiar with the franchise, even they're going to be very, very lost. And Peace Walker has been a game that's been kind of hard to access at the beginning because it was a PlayStation portable title and not many people own PSPs. It became available, I think, through the HD collection. So people who played the HD collection would have gotten a taste of Peace Walker, but even so, it's still a very it's not a game that's known by a lot of gamers. So that's kind of a thing. That is interesting, but in any case, Ground Zeroes has a very simple premise. It kind of goes back. It has a nostalgia factor to it in that it's all about kind of rescuing these two hostages.
Kept you waiting, huh?
From a, you know, the enemy territory. Although it's not actually enemy territory because it's, well, I guess to Naked Snake, Big Boss, it is more kind of a more enemy territory. You know, it is this Cuban base is being guarded by XOF forces, so to speak. And you know, it's kind of a throwback to Metal Gear Solid, which was also like, you know, Solid Snake going into Anchorage, Alaska, you know, the Foxhound base to rescue DARPA Chief and Kenneth Baker, the president of Arms Tech. Right, so in that way, a lot of throwback to this. Now, I'm not playing with the iPad app, but the iPad app allows me to kind of see that option map as I play along, and it's such a fantastic way to play this game with the iPad, but I'm choosing not to play the game with the iPad. Anyway, so this is what the game looks like on PlayStation 4. I'm very excited to continue playing. I'll end the video here and continue in the next video.